Thanks for sticking with us and welcome to this evening's Premier League Tonight. Just use the hashtag PL Tonight to join us. Look who has not lost his pace. From the commentary box to the studio in a matter of moments. How are you?
Didn't have any to lose.
Rubbish, you're too modest. You're like Marcus Rashford. If you want to join in the show, we'd love your thoughts, we'd love your comments. Please do get in touch. And Charlie Adam is also hopefully going to come and join us at some point. Charlie Watch is that he's in the shower at the moment and he never even came off the bench. And he's still having a shower before coming to join us. Right, let's go straight to the headlines before we get going this evening. Five-star City, Manchester City. As we know, they were playing a team who played with 10 men for a long time, but they still scored five, looked great today and were top of the league until this result for Manchester United. 100 up, Harry. Harry Kane and Glenn, I know, would love to talk about this. Harry Kane with his 100th and 101st goals for Spurs. What a player, and he scored them in not that many games either. And finally, Seagulls take flight. The importance of getting that first win of the season is so huge for a promoted side. Congratulations to all of the Brighton fans watching this because you've got your first one. Right, it's now time to talk Liverpool-Manchester City. We're going to start by hearing from Gareth, who's a Liverpool fan, Paul, who's a City fan. This is their day today.
Going to get the breakfast done, heading to Manchester, and then we'll see what the team news is.
There will definitely be goals, probably at either end, so I'm really looking forward to it and about to make the trip now.
Heart says 3-1, head says 1-1, so intriguing the afternoon in store.
Coutinho's a special talent. It could have been worth for me throwing him on the bench and giving him 20 minutes here today, so let's hope we don't end up regretting that one. Half-time, 2-0 down, 10 men, long way back for the Reds. Can't see us getting back into this one. Don't know what happened on Mane's red card, really. We only seen it in real time. We haven't seen any replays. Looked a harsh decision to me. Maybe wrong by the replays, but, you know, long way back for Liverpool now.
5-0, really pleased with that at the start of the season. Never would have expected that before the game. Brilliant performance from City in the second half. The game changed with the sending off. But City, I think, overall deserve to win.
It's just not our day. It all hinges on that red card decision. After that, pretty much game over. But some of the defending today was terrible. Not our day. Not our day.
It's amazing, isn't it? Two of the biggest teams go toe-to-toe. A 5-0 win for City and all we talk about is a sending off. And we'll discuss it in just a couple of moments also with Graham Pohl. But first, these are Jurgen Klopp's post-match thoughts on that red card for Sadio Mane.
He was shocked about the situation, and I'm sure also about the decision, because he didn't think if the leg is not where the leg is, you can also say it's a foul from the goalie. So what can I say? At the end, it's a red card, and I'm sure enough people will find enough reasons to say it was the right decision. So we cannot change it anymore. That's how it is. But of course, it had big influence on the game today. Yeah.
Well, as you heard there from Jurgen Klopp, Sadio Mane was shocked straight afterwards. And actually, he shared this on social media. I hope and wish Edison a quick recovery. I'm so sorry he was hurt during our accidental collision on the pitch. I'm sorry for him that he could not complete the match because of it. I pray he heals fast and is back playing very soon. And then this was shared by Edison, actually. And at the time, he was treated on the pitch for 7 minutes. It really did look horrible. Lots of question marks over how serious the injury was. Thankfully, we believe no broken bones. There he is, almost with a smile on his face. There's a Benjamin Mendy tweet with the picture saying, half crazy is here, everything good. I suppose half crazy, because I think to be a goalkeeper, you have to be, don't you? To put your head in the situation like that.
They're a different breed. But I believe it's a red card. I think 10 years ago, it's probably debatable. And people would say maybe you get a yellow card. But in today's day and age, with the rules the way they are, it's dangerous play, and as simple as that. And up to that point, Liverpool were probably the better team. They were the more dangerous team, and that game changed on that decision.
OK, well, let's get clarification straight away then from Graham, who's been part of the team all day and has manfully hung around for quite a long time to join us for the show. So I thought it'd be funny, Graham, not to go to you at all, but that would just be pure cruel. Right, it's just a red, you said to me earlier, and you used the phrase 100% a red. There's no doubt in your mind.
No, there isn't, Jake. And from a referee's point of view, you see things very black and white in that situation. You see how high Mane's foot is. You know he's caught the keeper in the face. So therefore, it's a very, very straightforward decision for a referee. I think Rio referred to maybe 10, maybe 15 years ago. It wouldn't have been, because there used to be a thing where things had to be intentional. And now that's been taken away. You've made your intent by making the challenge and putting your foot that high. and therefore you have to live with the consequences.
Chris Williams shared a social media post saying, never a red card, he has to challenge for the ball. Mane's eyes are fixed on the ball and Ederson dips his head in. And there's lots of people saying it can't possibly be a red card because Sadio Mane had no intent to hurt the player. Just explain what the rules tell us about that.
Well, as I say, apart from handball, which has to be intentional, every other offence, the letters of intent has been taken out. So it's actually what you do, it's the offence you do as opposed to what you mean to do. We know that Mane didn't mean, I don't believe, meant to hurt or catch Ederson, but it's what he does. He goes in at pace. There is intensity in the challenge. You can see from the amount it's caught the keeper by. The point of contact on the body, how high it is. It's ticking all the boxes. It has endangered the safety of the keeper without question. And therefore, that's why, as I say, it's 100% red card.
There's another comment here on social media saying from Lee 96 Fuller, if he got a toe to it and it went over the keeper, would that have been fine? Does it make any difference at all that Mane didn't win the ball? Imagine if he got the ball and still took the keeper.
Hypothetical situations are always hard to judge on because you need to look at what's happened. If he's got a toe on the ball and he's probably a yard or so away from the keeper, then you'd say, some referees would say, well, it's still dangerous, but it's no contact, so I'd still give a free kick. Some would say, no, he's got the ball clean. And then you've got the keeper, of course, crashing into Mane himself. And then you're going, it's a goal-scoring opportunity denied. So they're hypothetical things that are very hard to comment on.
Yeah, it's very difficult, isn't it? But if he does win the ball, he's gone to win the ball. His eyes are fixed on the ball, so it's an accident. But if he wins the ball and the goalkeeper clears him out, the keeper's sent off and it's a free kick to Liverpool. That's how close it was, but he didn't. He didn't win the ball. You put your foot up that high, you've got to win the ball. And even then he might say it's dangerous play, the referee still, even if he wins the ball and taps it over the goalkeeper's head. But for me, it's a red card all day long.
Yeah, it's an unfortunate one because I think we all agree that he's never meant to hurt the goalkeeper in any way, shape or form. He's gone for the ball. The ball's there. He's trying his best for his team to score a goal. However, the consequences are he's badly injured the goalkeeper and his foot's in his face and it is dangerous play and that's what the law says.
And what about, and this is one for you as well, Graham, for all of you really, what about the comments, and there were loads of them on social media saying the game's gone. You know, he didn't mean to hurt him, therefore you have to ignore the fact that the keeper got injured and respect the fact that Mane was playing the ball. Otherwise you're going to have sendings off all over the field. I mean, it's a hard one, that, isn't it, with the injury to the keeper?
If his foot was going into his leg or something like that, it's going into his head. It's like a karate kick. Look how high up he is. Look how high his foot is. It is dangerous. No matter how you look at it, no matter if there's intent or not, that is dangerous. I've been guilty of that in my career and I've given away free kicks like that. But you can't really argue when you see it like that. It's difficult to really defend
yourself.
It's not
like the goalkeeper's ducking down low, low down. It's high. And you've got to get it right. And in that split second, the referee doesn't get all the replays. He's got to make that decision. And I think he's made the right one.
All right. Graham, thank you very much for sticking around for that. We really appreciate it. You're a trooper.
Pleasure. Cheers,
Jake. Good man. Thanks a lot. One very small point. Rio started by saying if it was 10 years ago, it might have been allowed. In your day, when you were playing, would that have been a red card, do you think? Would you have...
30 years ago.
I didn't want to say that.
The keeper would have been told to get up and carry on.
It was different in them days. But I still think, I don't know, when you played abroad, that would always be a foul.
Yeah.
In any era. Mm. But in England, we were allowed to put your foot up a little bit higher in the era that I played in. Possibly, I don't, even though the foot has gone into the goalkeeper's head high, it's not low, I still think that might have been definitely a yellow card, maybe a red.
I would ask you how you would have felt in that situation being Mane, but I'm not sure the hamstrings would have allowed it, would they?
I'd have been on a stretcher.
You would have injured yourself getting up there. Yeah. Let's not talk about hamstrings.
I can't believe you were directing that question at him. Thanks, mate.
I know, I can't ask you about hamstrings.
Football, does it?
Yeah.
Well, that's a good question. All right, right. Well, let's move on then, talk about the margin of victory. It was a big margin of victory for City. So is that a reflection of the true difference between these two sides?
No.
It's hard to call it with a red, isn't it?
And your first question, Jake, was, you know, 5-0 to City, but we're talking about a red card. Well, that's because it had that effect on the game, and no way it would have been a 5-0 game had Liverpool had 11 men. Yes, Manchester City, better team on the day. They've got an amazingly talented manager and set of players, but, you know, Liverpool would never have lost 5-0 with 11 men.
Some teams wouldn't have taken the advantage that City did with the 11 against 10, but if there's any team you want to you know, not go down to 10 men against it's City with the prowess and the way they get their full-backs forward, the spare players that they find on the pitch. It was going to be a hard day for Liverpool. I think Klopp said about his half-time speech, you know, in the dressing room was, hey, guys, you know, it's in his eyes, it was an unjust sending off. But we were a match, if not better, for them, yeah. 11 v 11. And obviously it went south a little bit second half for them, but you've got to say, good finishing from City as well. Mm.
John Roberts actually sent a message here saying Liverpool didn't improve enough in the transfer window, still needed a better centre-half, still need a better keeper. How big are your question marks about Liverpool at the moment?
I said last season, defensively, I wasn't sure about them. They conceded too many chances. And I think the same this season. They seemed like they went hard to get Van Dijk. Didn't happen. And I think that's going to be probably their Achilles heel again this season.
OK, right, thank you very much for that. Keep your thoughts coming in. In a couple of moments, Charlie Adam is going to join us, I do believe. He's hovering outside the door, is that right? Great, well, we can't leave him hovering. It's his football club, we have to get him in here, so we'll do just that. If you'd like to share your three-word match reports, how your team performed today in just three words and the team that you support, we'll read them out after the break when Charlie Adam will be in here talking about Stoke. See you in a second.